kind of trouble could we get into today? Solid spruce top, Martin & Company, made in Mexico, U.S. patent number, yeah, whatever. This thing had such a severe back bow in the neck that the strings were actually touching all the frets. Like, you couldn't even play it. So I sort of had to make a little bit of a preemptive strike yesterday, because I don't even know if this thing will relax. Hey, I found my Martin wrench. It's over there. As opposed to last time that I couldn't find it. It's got some fret munch. A little bit, not too much. We're going to fix that up. I'm going to get all the strings off it and just put the neck in a straight condition with no strings on it.
So, 4 thou feeler gauge. Alright, this wonderful straight edge on there. And let's just go along. See where it touches. Looking pretty straight so far. I think we're okay. I'm way down here where you can't see.
Yeah, and then, you know, we can always have an eyeball look through and look for the light, right? No, that's great. It's nice and straight. So we're just going to start there. So what happened? We leveled them all out, and now we're going to embark on the crowning process with this marvelous piece of kit. Very expensive, but works very well and very fast. Right, so I've already done the 150 grit with the crowning file. Now I will do 300 grit, which is the flip side. Then we'll polish the hell out of them. So I hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving in America. I was hanging out yesterday with my old buddy Scully, and you may have heard me mention, you know, Scully's probably the most righteous, famous guitar tech equipment wizard that I know, right? You know, he spent a decade and a half working for Geddy Lee, and him and Geddy Lee still have a good friend type relationship. And then recently, I mentioned this too, I think, is that he just finished doing guitar tech for Jeff Beck. So, you know, right? But anyway, we had a good conversation. We start because Scully's a great player and he writes songs, and we were just talking about songwriting and how it all works. And he was explaining to me how Rush actually write a song. And I thought this was a pretty cool story. So Neil sends all his lyrics and words to Geddy Lee. Okay. That's what happens first. Then Geddy and Al get together, and apparently Al is a genius with the drum loops, right? So basically what they do is they create a demo with drum loops, him and Geddy Lee, of what they're going to do. They take that demo, which is, you know, time consistent, it's a drum machine, into the studio, and then Neil comes back in. He's never heard the song. He doesn't even know what his words are going to turn into. They play him the demo, and he works up a real drum track to go along with what they've laid out. Once he's accomplished that, the other guys go back and replace everything within the demo in a more grandiose production approach. I thought it was a pretty cool thing. And he does one song a day on drums. One song. He'll do, listen to a song, tackle it, create drum parts, do a performance, and that's it. I thought that was a cool story. Okay, so now I'm going full hog. Flapper method. 320 grit. And my flapper thing, I've showed this before, but I'll show it again. I don't even remember where I got it. But this is like a little flexible piece of rubber for detail sanding, like for refinishing furniture and shit, right? But it's just the right thickness of rubber that it just flaps back and forth, and you can hold on to it. See all the fun I get to have? You know, so after a million fret leveling, crowning, dressing, polishing adventures, what I could do is I could keep flapping and go through every grit of sandpaper. But what I've moved on to using are these wonderful 3M products. A little on the price side, but they do last a long time, and they're washable and they're flexible. So as far as polishing frets go, I'll get the camera over here and show you in a minute, but you know, as long as the fingerboard's protected with tape, rocking and rolling. So I still haven't done the ultrafine. I've done fine. I have done ultrafine. What's this one? This is microfine. Sorry, I haven't done microfine. And that usually gets it. I can go up one more with 2,000 grit paper if I want to. So apparently, this guitar is definitely a player. I mean, you can tell someone strummed this sucker. And it's about 7 years old. So I don't know how much, you know, drive time it's had, but it's been played. Probably get another fret dress out of this, another level, one more time, if you don't let it get too bad. And for sure, you'll get another few more years out of it before it gets the way it was, the way we saw it. So let's peel the tape off, put some strings on it, and see what it does. And we're having Martin 12 to 54. That should pull some neck tension back on this sucker and make it work the way it's supposed to. So right now I've got three strings on it tuned to pitch. So rather than put it into a heart attack, let's just see how much that has moved the neck. All right. Right now, it is still way too straight. So I am going to pop this guy in here right now. Come on, you can find it. There's no hair on it. Right, tight, left, loose. So right now, I don't think they've put a two-way in this. Or maybe they have. I'm not feeling any. Yeah, it's a two-way. Okay. It's all going to be good. What have we got now? Rightio, what happened? What happened? Did it go the other direction? A little bit. We'll stop there and add the other three strings. So now with full string tension, I'll stop there. I'm going to let it sit for a bit. Just make sure it's all tuned up to pitch, and I'll come back and just check it again, because it was really, really out of whack. Looks nice now, though. Well, it's a time to cut the strings and sign off. This thing's good. String action is very nice. And once again, we'll let it sit for a little while. Measure everything again, mainly because it was so badly out of adjustment. I don't know. I'll say this. It's a testament to the truss rod system in this, because it was
banana that direction, and I actually had the ability to make it go the opposite direction like a bow and arrow, so.
Martin and Company, 00X1AE. Cheers, folks. All the crafts below. Take care of yourselves. Later.